Let's have some fun with numbers. Let's see how to form a magic square super fast. I'm sure most of you must have tried creating a magic square sometime or the other, and you must have figured out that it's a really, really tedious process to fill in the magic square with the numbers such that all the rows, columns, and the diagonals add up to a same sum. So in today's video, we will see how to form a magic square really fast. But before that, let us see what is a magic square. As it is a square, the number of rows and columns will be same. Number of columns will be same as number of rows. Okay, so in a magic square, the properties of magic square are, suppose you have a magic square which is 3 rows and 3 columns. So the size of the magic square is 3 by 3. So the first property, number of rows is equal to number of columns. The second property is that sum of all the rows, sum of row 1, sum of row 2, sum of row 3, all the numbers in row 1 their sum, numbers in row 2 their sum, and numbers in row 3 their sum, and sum of all the elements in column 1, sum of elements in column 2, sum of elements in column 3, also the sum of the diagonal elements and sum of this diagonal elements. So the second property of a magic square is that all these sums, the sum of all the rows, sum of all the columns, and sum of all the elements that lie on the diagonal are all same. Okay, and such square is called a magic square. Fine. And the third and a very important property of a magic square is that the number of rows or the number of columns, as they are both same, should always be odd number. So it means that a magic square can be of size 3 rows by 3 column. It can be of size 5 row by 5 column, 7 row by 7 column, and so on. It has to be, the number of rows and columns have to be odd. It can't be, you can't have a magic square which is 4 by 4, 2 by 2, or maybe 6 by 6. You can't have a magic square which has even number of rows and columns. Now, there are certain rules to form a magic square. Okay, they're very simple rules. You can learn those rules and you can impress your friends by forming the magic square in just a couple of seconds. So let us see what are those rules. We will be learning the rules as and when we form a magic square. So let us try forming a magic square at the smallest magic square, a 3 by 3 magic square. So 3 rows and 3 columns. Okay, let me draw it here. The first rule says, let me draw a line here. Always place the number 1 in the middlemost block of last column. Okay, so which is our last column here? The last column here is this, and the middlemost block is this, we have placed a 1 here. That is the first step. What is our second step? Place the next number by always moving southeast. Okay, so we know that these are our four directions: north, south, east and west. And where does our southeast lie? This is southeast. So the second rule says that we always have to move southeast to fill in the second number in the square. So in this case, from 1 we have to move southeast in this direction. So the block that comes is this block. Now this particular block is lying outside the magic square. It becomes an imaginary block. So and we know that the number 2 has to go in this block. So where do we place number 2? We can't keep the number 2 outside the block. So comes the third rule. The third rule says what? The third rule says, if the block if the southeast block rather is outside this magic square, I'll just write MS for a magic square, then place that number in the farthest block. Okay, so now here we see that the 2 is in that imaginary block that's lying outside. So what we will do is we will place 2 in the farthest block. So the block which is farthest to this imaginary block is here, and we write the number 2 here. We again move southeast from 2. So we get a block right here which is again outside the number 3 here. So we have to move it to the farthest block. Farthest block from here is right here. Correct? So we place a 3 here. Okay, so we are able to place 3 numbers properly. Now when we move southeast, what do we see? When we move southeast, we see that the block is already occupied by some number. So there comes the rule number 4. What does the rule number 4 says? If there is a number in the southeast block, then move west and then take a southeast step. Okay, I have to draw the square again. We kept the 1 here, we moved southeast to the farthest block, we kept a 2 here, we moved southeast to the farthest block, we brought a 3 here, and now we moved southeast and we saw that there is a number 1. So we apply rule number 4, and where do we move? We move to the west. So we keep a 4 here. Okay, now again we will take the southeast step. So from 4, if we move southeast, we reach this block which is empty. We can fill it by a 5. We again move southeast. We get this block which is empty. Inside the square, we can move it to the 6. Now, when we come out here, we are coming out diagonally. We can't place a number here. We will be moving to the west to fill this block with 7. From this step, we again move southeast. So we reach a block here and we know that there is a farthest block, this thing. We put an 8 here, again move southeast. You reach to this block here which is outside the imaginary block. So we again move to the farthest block which is right here and we fill in 9 here. See, we have filled in all the blocks of a 3 by 3 magic square. Okay, so if you keep all the step in the mind and try creating a magic square, you can just create any size magic square in just couple of seconds. We will do one more. Let us do a 5 by 5 magic square. I will not keeping one in the middlemost block of the last column. Move southeast. You get a block here, which is outside. So move to the farthest and keep your two here. Okay. Now move southeast. You put a 3 here. Again move southeast. You reach to this block. So move to the farthest and place a 4 here. Move southeast again. The block is empty. Put a 5. When you try moving southeast, you see that there is a 1. So you move to the west. Put a 6 here. Again move southeast. You get a 7. Again move southeast. Get a 8. Again move southeast. You reach this block. So move to the farthest and put a 9 here. Move southeast again. You reach here. Put a 10 and take it to the farthest block. Now when you move southeast, you see that there is a 6. So you will move to the west and you will write an 11. Again southeast 12. Again southeast 13. Southeast 14. Southeast 15. Now you are going out diagonally. You will not go out diagonally. So you have to move west and you write a 16 here. Move southeast again. Block here. It can be moved to the farthest. 17 comes here. Bring out. Block comes here. Imaginary block with an 18 here. It has to be moved to the farthest. So 18 comes here. Southeast 19. Southeast 20. Now when you try moving southeast, you see that there is a 16. So you move to the west to write a 21. Move southeast 22. Again southeast, you reach a block which is outside. Fill it with 23 and move it to the farthest block. Southeast again 24. Southeast again from here, you reach a block here, which is again an imaginary block outside. So move it to the farthest. We just took a couple of seconds to form a big 5 by 5 square and you can try checking it. Try adding all the rows, columns and the diagonals and you will see that all are same. So this is a 5 cross 5 magic square. This is my email ID keerthi.mathacademy@gmail.com and this is my YouTube channel Math Academy. If you want more such Vedic maths tips and techniques, you can send me an email on the above ID. And if you have liked my video, please don't forget to subscribe on my channel. Thank you.